Hey everyone, real quickly, we want to weigh in on this thing about accessory muscles and by this particular individual that's out there marketing themselves as a fitness professional, as a celebrity fitness person. And one thing we wanted to also add to their plan is that one particular workout, the TA method, they include a diet. And most of these people that have their DVDs and that are out there marketing on their websites with infomercials, they all typically have some kind of, quote, diet or meal plan. Now, with this particular individual, several people have weighed in, including people that are registered dietitians, and these are the people that you want to listen to, not necessarily a nutritionist, totally. But that's not to say nutritionists are not valid, but a registered dietitian has been to 4 years of school, and they have to be licensed, meaning they take a test in their particular state to actually practice nutrition. So they are giving you sound advice, anybody that's a registered dietitian, for the most part. But we have documents, and we will put this down in the link, where registered dietitians have weighed in on the diet that comes with the, quote, TA method. And this diet is, in my opinion, very dangerous in that it restricts you to about a very low caloric intake. I've read as low as 1,200, and yet this individual wants you to do their workout, which is a lot of muscle work, even though they're lifting, quote, light weights. But they want you to work out like about six times a week. Now, anybody that's doing intense workouts, especially strength training, whether you're using body weight or whether you're using regular weights, if you are doing regular weighted workouts or even cardio, you are going to require more than 1,200 calories per serving or per day. That's what we're trying to say. You're going to require more than 1,200 a day. Otherwise, what's going to happen is if you get that and less and you're working out that intensely or that much during the week, your body is going to go into a starvation mode. And yes, you will lose some weight, but it's not going to be a healthy weight loss. And it's not going to stay, because as soon as you start eating regular foods, even regular healthy foods, you're going to gain weight. And plus, you're not going to get the muscle mass that you need lifting 2 or 3 pound weights. It's one thing if you're just starting out, ladies. If you've never done weights, that's one thing. But if you've been lifting for any time over a month, 6 weeks, 8 weeks, or an extensive amount of time, several months, you should not be lifting 2 to 3 pounds. You should be lifting probably almost double, if not almost triple that amount, definitely double. So anyway, please watch the, quote, so-called diets on these plans, and you just use common sense. But also, if you have to consult a nutritionist through your insurance, many insurance do subsidize it through low co-pays, or if not, then you'll have like a small portion to pay, and then your insurance company picks up the rest. I know that's how mine works. So anyway, please do not believe the hype with these things. Please, I cannot say enough. Look into this stuff and just be wary. Yes, that person is thin. They even use a celebrity named GP, and you'll know who that is. And if you look at GP's body and their body mass, that person does not have any muscles. And we're not talking about bulk, ladies. Please do not think bulk when we say muscles. But that person is basically a thin pencil. They have no muscle definition at all. And, you know, God knows how many diets or plans that they may have been on before they even came to, quote, TA. So anyway, we want to mention that to you. Please don't believe the hype. And please do not go the way of gimmicks. Remember, it's always well to live well. Take care, and you have a good one now. Bye-bye.